We are discussing about circulatory system. Circulatory system helps to transport the material in the body. It consists of heart, blood vessels, blood capillaries. Already learned about internal structure of the heart. So heart pumps the blood to every part through the blood vessels. If you observe this, from heart, the blood is supplied to every cell in the body through two different types of blood vessels. The red color ones are arteries, the blue color ones are veins. For diagrammatic explanation, they are given in the two colors, but actually in the body, they are not in the same appearance. Okay, let us, before discussing about the structure, function of these two types of blood vessels, let us see the structure. Here you see, these are arteries, these are veins. Arteries and veins. When you see the artery, around this there is a fibrous coat. Fibrous coat. So below this there is a muscular layer. Here also muscular layer. And below that there is a single layer of cells which made of endothelium. It's made of endothelium. So first the fibrous coat, elastic fibrous coat, next muscular layer, next a single layer of endothelium. So in middle you can see the empty space that is called as a lumen. Lumen. See the structure of vein. It also have the same three layers. So outer fibrous coat and muscular layer and a single layer of endothelium here also. But you see the difference to the artery and vein. The muscular layer is very thick. In the veins, the muscular layer is thin. So arteries are thick when compared to the veins. Next you see the lumen. It has a narrow lumen. But vein has a large lumen. What is the reason means? In heart blood flow with high pressure. In veins blood flow with low pressure. Because arteries have to supply the blood throughout the body from heart. For that it need pressure. Heart gives that pressure through heartbeat. Arteries carry the blood from heart to body parts. Veins carry the blood from body parts to heart. That's why in veins blood flow with low pressure. Hence it has a thin muscular layer and has a large lumen. The lumen size decreases, the pressure increases. One more point. If you observe in the veins, there are walls. Walls we discussed in the heart. Four types of walls. Bicuspid, tricuspid, systemic walls and pulmonary walls. So walls are also present in veins. They are absent in arteries. So this is the structure of arteries and veins. And third one, blood capillary. Blood capillary structure is very simple. They are very thin blood vessels. The thickness is like hair. Okay. Very filamentous. They are discovered by Marcello Malpighi. Scientist Marcello Malpighi discovered blood capillaries. So they do not have the fibrous coat muscular layer. Just they made of a single layer of epithelium tissue. So what are the differences to arteries and veins? Let us see that. So arteries are thick when compared to the veins. The lumen size is narrow in artery, it is large in veins. In arteries, blood flow with high pressure because they supply the blood to body parts. In veins, blood flow with low pressure because yes, sir, they carry the blood from body parts to heart. Another one, in the veins, walls are present. In the artery, walls are absent. Why do in artery walls are absent means? In arteries, blood flow with the same pressure. They do not need walls. Blood flow with the help of pressure. Moreover, it moves from heart to body parts towards the gravitation. Heart to body parts means towards the gravitation. But in veins, from lower body parts to heart mainly. That means against the gravitational force. Then what will happen? The blood try to move backward direction, right? Mostly the blood trying to from down to up. So blood try to move back. To prevent the backflow of blood, veins have the walls. The walls close and prevent the backflow of the blood. So this kind of differences you can see. The blood capillaries connect the arteries and veins. The arteries divides into various branches. Finally, they divide into very fine branches. They are blood vessels, blood capillaries. They are connecting links to the arteries and the veins. Okay, I said that arteries supply the blood from heart to body parts, but except one artery. What is that one? Pulmonary artery. In heart structure you learn pulmonary artery. It carries the blood from heart to lungs. Of course, lungs are also body part, but type of blood is different. All arteries carry the oxygenated blood from heart to body parts. Oxygenated blood. But pulmonary artery carry the deoxygenated blood from heart to lungs for purification. Next, veins. All the veins carry the deoxygenated blood from body parts to heart, except pulmonary vein. The pulmonary vein carry the oxygenated blood from lungs to heart. Understand? All arteries carry the oxygenated, except pulmonary artery. All veins carry deoxygenated, except pulmonary veins. So this is about blood vessels. Now let us discuss how the heart works. We can discuss the function of heart through cardiac cycle. The next topic is cardiac cycle. The living thing life starts with the embryo. So human's life also starts with the embryo in mother womb. When you are in embryonic stage, from a 21st day onwards, the heartbeat starts and it continues till the end of the life. Understand? So let us see how it works. Have you listened the heartbeat? Okay, two types of sounds you can listen. You may listen. What are they?
Lapdap.
Two sounds. So those are two sounds comprises one heartbeat. For that, once recall the structure of heart. It has four chambers. Upper chambers are auricles, lower chambers are ventricles, and the blood vessels. For right atrium, veins are connected, superior and inferior vena cava. For left atrium, pulmonary vein is connected. Next, for right ventricle, pulmonary artery is connected. From left ventricle, the largest artery, that is aorta, is connected. Next, walls are there. So between the right auricular ventricular septum, tricuspid valve is there. Between the left auricular ventricular septum, bicuspid valve is there. And between the right atrium and pulmonary artery, pulmonary veins, pulmonary valves are there. And between the left ventricle and aorta, systemic valves are there. Okay, now let us see how the blood pump, how the heart pump the blood to body parts. First, let us imagine all the chambers are empty. There is no blood. Okay, first, the blood enter the right atrium from the superior and inferior vena cava, and the blood enter to the left atrium from pulmonary artery. So both arteries fill with the blood. Whenever they fill with blood, they start contraction. This contraction phase is called systole. Systole means contraction of chambers. Here the arteries contracted, and that speed is called auricular systole. So whenever they contract, what happens? The pressure is applied on the blood. So the blood try to move to the lower chambers from high to low pressure through these valves. So blood enter the ventricles. Ventricles fill up with blood. Now whenever ventricles fill up with blood, they start contraction. Now arteries start a relaxation. This relaxation is called diastole. Diastole means relaxing. Understand? So when the arteries contract, that is auricular contraction. Auricular systole. When the arteries relax, that is called auricular diastole. When the arteries relax, ventricles contract. When the ventricles relax, arteries contract. It's a cyclical process. Okay, what happens when the ventricles fill up with blood? Now they start contraction. Ventricular systole, that is called. Then what will happen? The pressure is applied on the blood. Now the blood try to move in backward direction. That means from ventricle to arteries. To prevent this backward direction, the walls present between the arteries and ventricles close. Whenever they close, we can listen the sharp sound, that is lap sound. The lap sound created by the closure of walls between arteries and ventricles. So now the blood next move to the arteries. Due to close of these valves, the blood move to arteries. From left ventricle to aorta, from left right ventricle to, what is this?
Pulmonary artery.
So between ventricles and the arteries also valves are there. You have to remember that one. So from ventricles to arteries, blood move from high to low pressure. So arteries fill up with blood. So there is a low pressure in ventricles. The ventricles relaxes. Due to this relaxation, the pressure decreases in ventricles. At the same time, there is high pressure in arteries. So that's why blood try to move back from high to low pressure, from arteries to ventricles. To prevent this backflow, the valves present between ventricles and arteries close. Whenever they close, we can hear the dull sound, dub sound. Okay? So the first sharp sound is due to the closure of valves between arteries and ventricles. Second dull sound is due to the closure of valves between ventricles and arteries. So like this, due to this contraction and relaxation, or the systole and diastole, the blood flows to the blood vessels. The pressure created by the ventricles is enough to flow that blood, or supply that blood to all body parts in the arteries. Understand? The pressure of blood in the arteries created by the ventricles of heart. Understood? So this cardiac cycle completes within seconds only, very less time. So systole is a contraction phase or active phase. Diastole is a relaxation phase. So this is about the cardiac cycle. Okay, next another topic is the method of circulation through the heart. Circulation method. So before that, you have to know the number of chambers in the heart. In vertebrates, that means animals with the backbone, there are five phylums are there. What are they? First one fishes, second amphibians, third reptiles, fourth birds, fifth one mammals. In fish, two chambers are there. Amphibians, three chambers. Reptiles, also three chambers. The fourth chamber is incompletely divided. That's why we say it has three chambers. Birds and mammals have the four chambers. Humans belongs to mammals. That's why you have the four chambers. See here, this diagram shows the blood circulation in fish. It has two chambers only. Upper chamber, lower chamber. One auricle and one ventricle. This diagram shows the blood circulation in humans or mammals. It has four chambers. First, let us see the circulation in fish. Here you can start from any point. For example, the blood circulation starts in the auricle. From auricle the blood reaches the gills. In any fish, the gases exchange takes place in the gills. They work like lungs in our body. So the blood reaches the gills. Here the blood is purified. Purified means the carbon dioxide removed, oxygen is added. From here, from gills, the blood is not reached the heart again. From gills, the blood directly is applied to the body parts. Body parts. Again, from body parts, gases exchange takes place. That means oxygen used by cells and carbon dioxide is added. The deoxygenated blood again reaches the heart. How many times the blood circulated through the heart? No, only one time. One time. From ventricle to auricle. Only one time. That's why it is called as single circulation. To complete one circulation, blood flows only one time through heart. That's why it is single circulation. Let us see here. You can start from any point. It has four chambers. Let us start at left auricle. How the blood flows from left auricle to left ventricle? Left ventricle to left ventricle to say aorta. Aorta. So here blood flows one time. Left auricle to left ventricle one time. So from aorta supply the blood to the body parts. In body parts gases exchange occur. From body parts the blood is again supplied to the heart through the pulmonary through the superior and inferior vena cava. They carry the blood to the right auricle. From right auricle the blood flow to the right ventricle. This is the second time. One time between left auricle and left ventricle, second time between right auricle and right ventricle. So the right ventricle supplies the blood to the lungs. In the lungs, the blood is purified. The purified blood again supplied to the left atrium by the pulmonary vein. So here, how many times the blood supplied through the chambers?
Two times.
That's what it is called?
double circulation.
Double circulation. Okay. So in the lower organisms, blood circulates one time. In higher animals, you can observe the double circulation. Okay. Let us go to another topic. Here we observe the arteries supply the oxygenated blood to the body parts. From body parts, which one carry the deoxygenated blood to heart? Veins, right? Artery supply to body parts. From body parts, vein carry the blood to heart. So arteries and veins are participating in the circulation. But here there is one more circulatory system which participates in the circulation. That is the lymphatic system. Lymphatic. Let us discuss about that one. Okay, listen. So before going to lymphatic system, you have to know the how the arteries and veins divide. See this one. This is the largest artery, aorta. So the aorta ladder divided into small branches. Those are called arterioles. Arterioles. Okay. The largest artery divided into small branches called arterioles. So again, these arterioles divide into very fine branches. They are called capillaries. Capillaries. Here veins also. The large veins divided into branches called venules. The venules again finally divided into capillaries. Here if you observe, the capillaries of both arteries and veins are joined together. But really that's not happens. So what happens when the capillaries reach the body parts? Body parts means cells of all tissues. So whenever they reach the cells, the blood present in the capillaries flows out. From capillaries, the blood flows out, come out. You know, in blood, two parts are there. The solid parts called blood cells, and liquid part, that is plasma. In blood cells, different types: white blood cells, red blood cells, and platelets. Plasma has a liquid portion, different types of proteins. Understand? Whenever the capillaries reach the cells, except the blood cells, the liquid portion comes out. The liquid portion consists of nutrients and gases. And some of the white blood cells also flows out from blood capillaries. Those white blood cells are lymphocytes. Remaining blood cells cannot come out. Okay, here the fluid flows out from the blood capillaries is known as tissue fluid. It's also known as lymph. What happens now? What happens when this tissue fluid is flowing over the cells? The cells use the oxygen and nutrients present in the tissue fluid. And cells add the waste materials like carbon dioxide and nitrogenous waste. Okay? Now what should happen? Again this tissue fluid. Should enter the veins. Because the veins should carry that deoxygenated blood to heart. But how it enter the veins? To supply the tissue fluid to the veins, there is a separate circulatory system, that is the lymphatic system. What is this one?
Lymphatic system.
What it do means, it collect the collect the tissue fluid and supply to the main circulatory system, that is venous system. So lymphatic system is a parallel system to the venous system. But finally, lymphatic system do not connect to the heart. Before reaching heart, the lymphatic system connected to the veins. So here lymph is very important in our body, because lymph consists of lymphocytes. What is the importance of lymphocytes? They play a very crucial role in fighting against diseases. Our immunity power depends on this lymphocytes. Whenever a virus or bacteria enters, these lymphocytes fight against them by releasing the antibodies. So that's why lymph is important. So there is a difference to the blood and the lymph. In blood you can see solid parts and the liquid part. But the lymph consists only liquid part. It do not have the blood cells except lymphocytes. Okay? If you remove the liquid part from blood, if you remove the solid part from the blood, the remaining liquid portion is called serum.